Hawaii is testing thousands of people every day for COVID-19 to see how prevalent the virus is in our community. But are all tests created equal? Always Investigating scoured the numbers to find out. Gina Mangieri explains the differences.
One of the ways these tests vary is in how little of the virus they can detect in a sample. The most sensitive platform is churning out Hawaii's highest volume of tests.
Always Investigating surveyed state and private labs and found about 15 different testing platforms in use. Hawaii ramped up testing over the summer and positive cases spiked. Most tests were analyzed on the most sensitive platform in use in Hawaii, the Hologic Aptima. Just last week, the FDA ranked 55 authorized tests by limit of detection, the lowest amount of the virus the test can pick up. A lower LOD signaling a more sensitive test. Hologic's LOD was 3 times smaller than the Roche, also in use in Hawaii, and 30 times smaller than the CDC panel used at the state lab.
What you have to think about is, how often is that really significant? When somebody's really got the disease, there's enough virus on that swab to be detected even by the less sensitive CDC method.
That's the state laboratory's division administrator, who explained while Hologic has the advantage of high volume, it does not give key data doctors like to see for determining if someone is likely contagious or on the downswing or upswing of the virus cycle.
When you choose that instrument, you have to realize that you are giving up the ability to report a CT value.
CT value stands for cycle threshold, how much a virus sample has to get amplified to be detected.
A low CT value means that there was a lot of the virus there in the sample. And what they found at in the CDC studies is that when a person is no longer infectious and no longer has infectious virus that they can culture, their CT value seems to be above 33.
The vast majority of the state lab's positives have been under 30 CTs. About 1 in 5 are under 35, and fewer than 5% have been just below the cutoff of 40. They're not too worried about misdiagnosing anything above the cutoff as negative because the risk of missing oncoming COVID is minimal. High CT traces can stick around for weeks in people long recovering from COVID, whereas
people who are just developing their infection and have a low viral count at first and a high CT value, that only lasts for a few hours.
A low CT value does not mean a person feels stronger symptoms. Lieutenant Governor Josh Green tells me his CT was 20 on his state lab test positive COVID result, but his worst symptom was fatigue.
I also developed some cough over the last weekend, so it was just basically like I had an upper respiratory infection, not that unlike having a flu. I was in the very mild symptom category.
That's been the experience for most of the people who got COVID during the summer spike, in which positives shifted to majority younger, generally healthier, and often asymptomatic people. Average daily positives shot up more than 1,000% between mid-July and late August, adding thousands of cases. But hospitalizations remained in the hundreds, and the ICUs spiked below 60. The Federal Department of Health and Human Services has not provided CT ranges or equivalents for the Honolulu surge testing. But the FDA ranks those HealthQuest tests, which have you swab your nostril, as about as sensitive as the state lab's deep sample method.
You got a slightly higher number of positives from the nasopharyngeal, from the deeply inserted swab. But the difference was slight and not statistically significant. My feeling at the moment is that the nasal swabs are good.
At last count, the DHS had processed about 58,000 Honolulu surge tests and found nearly 350 positive. That's a much lower rate than other lab and clinic tests of those sick and exposed, whereas the surge tested anyone who wanted one.
This shows that with 0.6% of them positive, that we've got 6,000 people in our population who are not diagnosed. And when you look at that number, you think, I want to wear a mask.
Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, Always Investigating.